Okay, everybody. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, whatever time you are in. You know what time is it? It's time for us to do some more word problems today. And malapit na ba kayo mag-exam? Kung malapit na kayo mag-exam, ganito yung mangyayari na yun. Kasi po na yun, malapit ang finals ng exam namin sa general mathematics. So kung sa timo kayo guys, kung nahihirapan na kayo sa math, why don't you follow along guys with me para what you all this, mahusay na kayo sa pag-aaral. Now, I know naman for the second grading, we are going to learn these types of concepts. Pero ganito kasi yung mangyari. Sinabi ko sa iyo, malapit na yung finals. And to keep you guys started, mag-review muna tayo everything what you've learned so far. So you're gonna review all the concepts that you're gonna learn with me para what you all this, pag dumating na kayo sa exams, matuloy na kayo. So mag-review muna tayo. Okay, so our first item is letter A, expand each logarithmic expression and vice versa. Ah, kasi nga ang nangyari na yon sa school namin, di ba dapat ang logarithms dapat ay tinatapos sa uling parte ng first grading o tinatawag sa midterms. Kaso lang, ang sabi ng teacher ko, hindi na tayo natuloy, kaya naman natuloy tayo yung logs sa finals. Pero that was just the minor lang of logs. Kasi ang gagawin namin na yon ay i-condense na namin at saka i-expand. So, di ba remember when we say expanding and condensing logs using the property of logs as follows? Like, di ba remember sabi ko sa'yo, ito yung properties ng logs. Like, for example, we have the product law. Wait lang. Ang product law. Kapag sinasabi na product law, ano yun? Ang sinasabi ng product law, like for example, you have log 10 plus log 1,000. This can be written as log 10 times 1,000. Diba? Naka-bracket na yan. Which simplifies to, diba yung 1,000 times 10 equals 10,000. Pero ano yung log ng 10,000? Ang sagot dyan ay 4. Bilangin mo yung zeros, diba? Pero if you were to do this separately, kapag ginawa mo yun individually, diba log of 10 is 2. Is 1, diba? Log 1,000 is 3. Adding the two numbers, you get 4. So this checks. Yun ang product law. Ang product law ng log. Now, what about quotient law? Ang sinasabi dito sa quotient law ay ganito. Quotient law, ibig sabihin, mag-subtract kayo. So, ito ang quotient law. Ganito kasi yun. So, quotient law. Quotient law naman. Halimbawa, meron tayong log 1 million minus log 10,000. If you were to write this as a quotient law, pwede namin tayo i-write. We can rewrite this as log 1 million, di ba, naka-fraction na yan, that's quotient law, over 10,000. Tapos, ang gawin na namin, i-cross out namin yung zeros. 1, 2, 3, 4. And that's 100 over 1. So, it becomes log over 100 na lang. And log over 100 is 2. Diba? Diba, statistics, kung nakita mo sa log, kapag walang, ano yun, walang base number doon sa baba, ibig sabihin, automatic 10 na yan. And your answer is 2. That is the answer. Or, kapag sinimplify, if you were to get this, diba, log base 10 of 1,000, that's supposed to be 6. Count the zeros. And then, log base 10 of 10,000 is 4. 6 minus 4 is 2. Checks. Diba? Yun ang quotient law. Kapag may division, i-subtract na namin. Kapag in-expand mo, tapos nakita mo ay negative, ibig sabihin, i-subtract mo ang log. It's going to be subtracted. Yun ang quotient law. I-divide na namin. It's just like when you use the laws of exponents. Kasi nga, remember, yung answer makukuha mo sa log ay exponent. Kaya nga, if you are going to expand the log, you're going to apply subtraction, addition and subtraction. Pero if you're simplifying the log, it's always multiplication and division. Pero when we get to my problems, when we get to the problems later on, makikita mo na yung mga plot twist na mangyayari. Kaya muna review muna tayo. The last one is what you call the power law. Ito yung paborito ko. ang power law. Power law. Ang power law naman ay halimbawa kapag ganito. Let's say for example, you have log base 5 of 25 cubed. Diba? So ganito yung mangyayari. What is 25 cubed? I-type na namin sa Microsoft Excel. Pero what you always, I'll try to solve it here na lang. So 25 cubed is this. Ang 25 cubed, diba 25 times 25 is 625. 625 times 25, 5. 5 times 2 is 10. Plus 2, 12. That's 3,125. And this becomes, ano yun? 1,250. Tama ba? 50. Tama, 1,250. Tapos, yun nga, the answer is supposed to be 1,260. 15,625. Kaya naman, ang 25 cubed ay 15,625. Now, if I were to take the log of that number, since it's a very big number, I'm afraid to use calculator. Pero let's say, halimbawa, kapag hindi mo gagamitin yung calculator, this is very easy. Ganito kasi yun. I will show you what you're gonna do now. Kapag sinabi power law, di ba, nakita mo to, ito yung exponent. Ito ay tinatawag na anong tawag dito? Ang tawag dito ay exponent. So, di ba yung memory kung sa team mo, ito yung exponent, di ba? So, ito ang exponent. This is the exponent. Ang gawin mo lang sa exponent, di ba yung memory sabi ko, ang log ay ang trans, ay ang makukuha mo ng value ng exponent. Like, for example, you take the log base 10 of 100, ano yung exponent namin? Dalawa. 2. Di ba? So that's the, so that one, di ba remember yung log na sagot? Di ba remember this is the base? Kapag tinranslate mo to sa exponential equation, di ba ito yung base? So that is going to be 5. 5 raised to what power gives you 25 cubed? Di ba? Ito yung sagot. 25 cubed. And then when we applied solving for exponential equations, di ba 5x, that becomes 5x. Then find a base that is familiar. And that is 5 squared cubed. Then, when the bases are identical, it becomes x equals 6. So, yun yung sagot. So, therefore, log base 5 of 15,625 is 6. Pero, another thing I would like to tell you is about the power law. Diba, you guys were asking me, sir, ano ba to yung exponent na yan? Kung kapag may sagot dyan. Dito na talaga maglagay ng twist. You see the exponent here? Ilagay namin sa unahan. Kasi nga naman, remember, it's being multiplied. Diba power law, let's say for example, if you have an exponent that is raised to another power, ibig sabihin, you multiply the exponent. So diba remember kung kinuha mo yung sagot dito, you're going to get the value of the exponent. And then the exponential value here, doon sa sagot na makukuha mo sa log, that you're taking the log base within that specific base of, will jump to the front, in front of, behind the log, making it be multiplied by taking the log of that number. Yan! So therefore, it's going to be, di ba remember nakita mo yung tatlo? The 3 jumps in front of the log base 5. So therefore, it will be written like this. 3, can you see what I'm doing? 3 times log base 5 of 25. Ayan, mas madali na yan. Di ba remember, sinabi ko, ang log base 5 ng 25, ang sagot dito ay, what is the answer of taking the log base 3 of 20, log base 5 of 25? That's 2, di ba? So 3 times 2. Log base 25 is 2. And 3 times 2, ano yung sagot? 86. So tama, that is the power law. So these are the 3 laws that you have to apply when it comes to condensing or expanding a log. Every time when you're asked to expand a log, the number that comes before the log is always the exponent that you have to bring up. Okay? Now I will show you the example so that you will know exactly what's the principle. Ready? Get set, go! Tandaan mo yung mga formulas namin ha. Tandaan mo yung mga laws of logs that I discuss para we can answer the activity. Are you ready? Let's do this. Kaya namin to. Okay, so number one, we have ln. Oo nga pala, for the sake of some people, bakit tinatawag na ln? That, yes, that's equivalent to a log. Pero you're going to take a log of a specific number called e. Ang E na tinatawag na ito. E. That's what you call Euler's number. And I know naman, if you're not a pro, you do not know what that is. But I know yung Euler, I 2.718, 2. Whatever you call that. I do not know what are the other numbers there. And that's what you get with the natural log. That's how they do it. Okay? Now, it says, now don't mind the natural log. What is important, just what I said, you can only play the game of condensing or expanding a log if and only if the bases are of your logs, base, the bases of your logs are congruent. Kapag hindi sila pantay, ibig sabihin, hindi pwede mo i-combine. Like for example, di ba remember sabi ko, you have log base, like di ba remember going back to our review example, you have log, walang base, plus log na walang base of that specific number. Wala tayong base, and they are all congruent. Ibig sabihin, you can apply the rules of, the laws of logarithms called product law, quotient law, and power law. Yun ang tawag na laws of logarithms. You should have the same base. Now, what if, pero kung gano'n naman, let's say for example, di ba yung remember ask me kapag naiba yung laws of logs? Like for example, you have, for example, log base 7 of 343 minus log base 5 of 625. Of course, there is no way for you to combine the log. Hindi pwede mo i-combine. You will just have to solve that individually. And diba log base 7 of 343 is 3. Log base 5 of 625 is 4, which will give you negative 1. Hindi pwede mo siya i-combine yung log. You cannot combine it because the logs, the bases of the logs, are not congruent. Because they say you need to master talaga combining logs and expanding them so that when you solve for logarithmic equations, this is the principles that you use. Ayun pala, if you've watched pala my previous video in mathematics, doon sa periodical test, I also put there solving for logarithmic equations. And ino naman talaga, this also implies the application of this one, which I haven't shown you yet. Pero for the sake of beginners of logs, this is for you. Okay? Huwag na tayo sa inyo oras now, let's get to the problem. So sabi ko, we have log ln of A plus ln of B plus ln of C. Diyan mo lahat. Naka-plus na yan. Everything's all plus. So what we do now? Di ba remember, this is addition or subtraction. Tandaan mo, kasi nga for the sake of some people, actually to tell you my story, when I studied this before, I kind of get baffled talaga. I really, really get baffled talaga when it comes to this type of game. Pero when we say expanding, you're adding and subtracting. Like, do you remember when you play the game of expanded form? Like, write, like for example, write 12,560 in expanded form. To do this, you write 10,000 plus 2,000 plus 500 plus 60. Tandaan mo, kapag i-expand mo yung logarithm, it just so happens that implies the application of addition. So if you remember this, try to remember the time when you were in elementary na tinuro mo yung guro mo na expanded form pala, i-add mo yung number. I-add mo like, i-add mo, adding the numbers of that specific place value. Pang, you're just remembering your, reminiscing your childhood life when you were in elementary. Like for example, mga grade 3, grade 4, grade 5, grade 6, and so on. Para what sure is makukuha mo yung sagot. Expanded form ng numero. That is how you expand a log. So, tandaan mo, kapag i-expand mo yung logs, yun dapat ang gagawin mo. There's addition and subtraction. If you're asked to condense a log, pero may maninikita mo, addition, huwag mo matitiwala yun. Just base it on the instruction. But I will show you the process as you go along with the course. Okay? That is expanding a log. Expanding the log. Pero when we say condensing, ibig sabihin shrinking, kung isisimplify mo, that is what you call multiplication and division. So, di ba remember, sinabi ko, kapag expand, it's always plus or minus. Ito yung mga simbolo na dapat maniniwala namin. Kapag sinabi condense, ibig sabihin, shrink, it's always multiplication and division. Bakit ganun? Tandaan mo talaga, kapag condensing, we are simplifying the numbers. Like for example, di ba remember, simplifying into lowest terms, di ba? Or multiplying to get the lowest number. Like for example, do you remember last time when you have fractions? Tandaan mo, if you have, for example, 1 plus 5 divided by 5. Of course, you cannot cross out the 5s. This is the most mistake that students could make. Unless lang talaga, kapag 1 times 5 divided by 5, pwede mo i-cancel ang 5. Tandaan mo, to help you remember the expanding, which is plus or minus, is to help you is to remember that time when you were in elementary, such that when you write in expanded form of these given numbers, it's always plus plus plus. Pero kapag condensing a log, you always think talaga you want to simplify. How to simplify? You don't simplify with addition. You simplify with multiplication and division. Now that's how you remember how to think na kung multiply, kung condense, sir, paano mo i-condense? Yun nga, para what you always say, for example, you would ask your sir, your teacher, sir, yung condense ng logs ba addition or subtraction? Pero if he would say, hindi ako magtitiwala sa'yo, mag-aral ka na. Then you will have to remember talaga, simplify, big simple, like simplifying fractions. And we don't simplify fractions kapag addition. We only simplify fractions kapag multiplication or division. Such that we cancel out the factors. Yan. That's how you remember. And kapag i-expand mo, na remember the time when you expand, write numbers in expanded form when you're in elementary. Gets? So now let's go now to the concept. I think I'm explaining too much already with this type of stuff. Sorry guys. Pero for the sake of new learners, just bear it na. Pero for the sake of, pero unless you're an expert, just skip this part. Okay? Now going back to log of A, ln of A, ln of B, and ln of C. This log, what are you supposed to do here? Nakita mo may plus. So what do you think of when you see plus?